State Minister for Kampala, Kawiye Chofatogawie, and Kampala City Council Authority Executive Director Dorothy Kisaka have been grilled by COSASE on allegations that they covertly in the process of purchasing 10 acres of land in Kisenyi at a tune of 370 billion shillings.
Are you, as KCCA, in discussions with this Bosco Muonge of Boost Investments? Maybe help us understand that for starters.
But I told you the preamble was we want to buy land everywhere.
And that's okay. So we wanted to establish, because we heard about this,
yes,
Honorable
you
Minister.
Asked me the status.
Just a second.
Correspondence is privy to the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises indicate that KCCA in November last year expressed interest in John Bosco Muonge's land with the intention of providing market space for low-income earners in the city and also establish tax parks. The deal was, however, affected by land wrangles, and little has been heard ever since.
If you say, you know this, then you look at you as someone who is lying to the committee, and when we sit to make a report, you will be implicated for nothing.
Maybe the minister's response. I wish you could first be on record that you are aware of what they have read for you, because we have more documents. So we want to know whether you as KCCA management, you are aware of what is happening.
However, while interacting with MPs on the matter today, Ichofatogabe and Kisaka categorically denied buying this land. But they admitted that engagements are ongoing and they're being delayed by a due diligence which is yet to be done.
Are there? Because people have approached, including Mr. Bosco Muonge, in quotes, the owner of that plot. But like I said, you can't proceed unless when due diligence has been done and satisfies your mind.
We wrote to the chief government valuer to ask, is the word ask? To assess the value of the land and so that we could get into the formal processes.
But COSASE committee members sought to know how KCCA floated PPDA guidelines to zero on this land without public bidding. However, legislators tasked the minister and KCCA executive director to explain the arrangement under which KCCA settled street vendors on this land if they are not pushing for its procurement. Kisaka denied having any memorandum of understanding with Muonge over vendors' occupation of the controversial land.
Is it your submission that procurement of this particular piece at up to this level was done by the ED and the minister, not through the procurement office or the contracts office, but it is purely a matter being handled by the ED and the ministers, and who is
that
paying
is
for the
what advice? I have responded to. There are things we do as our administrative role around the city. Even now you're going to hear things we are saying about the floods. So you can't say, why are you helping the person with the petrol station yet it is not yours? It is part of our responsibility.
These revelations come on the back pedal of a January 5th, 2023 letter from the Permanent Secretary to the Treasury, Ramadan Gobi, directing KCCA to undertake due diligence on Kisenyi land.
Hold the Bible and take oath and then we proceed. But if you don't want, you can speak on the mic and say, I don't want. That's still okay, because I'm not going to hold you by force and hold your hand by force, no. So, procedurally, that's something we want you to do as a committee. But if you don't want, turn on your microphone and say, I don't want. And then we have that on record as well.
Yeah.
No. The only thing I want to hear is either I don't want or whatever.
It's better you educate somebody.
Okay.
I think that way.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm like, what is it for? The member just said, put a minister on oath.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.